What's up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of the Goober podcast. Today we have a special guest, two returning guests. I'm not going to introduce them, you know them. We have a new guest on the podcast. He's been called many things, the president. He's called the director. He's called everything. You know, he's a social guy. We got Sam Saperstein right here.
What's up, guys?
Yay.
What's up? So we got Sam on the pod. He watched one of the episodes and he was like, I got to get on. And I said, you're right. You know, I've been thinking about it for a while, getting Sam on, and now here we are. Thank you for bringing us to your house.
Yeah, of course. Yeah. Figured switch up the environment a little bit.
So. Exactly. The banner in the back. We're killing it. We like it. But Sam, tell us a little bit about yourself. You know, we met you through MSL, which is a sports management club, which I don't know if you know this. I'm actually not a sports management major. I'm just in the club.
I believe it.
But I'm business management. So, kind of works out. But yeah, tell us about yourself, you know, how you got into, how you started MSL, like getting into it and just,
Sure. Yeah. So, well, thanks for having me, first of all.
Of course. Of course.
Good to see you guys. Let's see, how did I get into MSL? Well, I think I told the story at elections, actually, but I, my freshman year, you know, was looking to be involved. It's easier said than done, you know, because with a lot of the clubs, there's usually like a large presence, and so it's hard to work your way up and XYZ, but I figured, you know, all you can do is start. So showed up at an MSL meeting after hearing about it in my intro class. I think the president at the time was Sam Bernstein. Also Sam, she came in and talked about MSL and I was like, wow, like she seems really cool. I thought she was really cool personally. So I was like, okay, the club's gotta be really cool.
Yeah.
So I went in, shout out to Sam, by the way. I went in and basically sat through the first meeting, really enjoyed it. It was like professional development when we brought somebody into Zoom. Mm-hmm. I forget who it was. I don't remember. But one of our alums, I guess, was working at the Orioles. He came in and spoke. I ended up afterwards reaching out and like it showed me that the club was really impactful because I was able to just email this guy. I got on a phone call with him and boom, that was like my first, I remember sitting in HAMP and like talking to him. I was like, wow. I was like looking at my dorm, I was thinking to myself, this is cool. Like I'm already like kind of being a part of the industry. But after the meeting, I approached Sam, the president, Ari, Nick, some of the people on the board. And kind of was just like all shy and my, you know, freshman self, but I'm a pretty outgoing person. So I was like, for me, it was shy. I was kind of just, you know, hey guys, how's it going? Like, my name's Sam. I really want to be involved, whatever. And I think immediately Sam Bernstein was like, oh, you have the same name as me. Like, I like this guy. You know what I mean? Yeah, and then as time went on, like not only Sam Bernstein, but the rest of the board was super nice. I would stay after every meeting and talk to them.
Yeah.
I don't even think I ever got like involved as far as like helping them with anything. This was when the club was still kind of, I don't want to say like we were just doing less as far as expansive stuff outside of professional development.
Yeah.
And so I didn't really get involved with anything like PBTO except, so technically my freshman year, I did do PBTO. I was on like the marketing team, which was really cool. And it showed me that MSL really does do things like physical events. And I was like, man, I really see the potential for this club. I want to be involved. And then election time came and they elected me to the general board. I ran for marketing and didn't win, but it was awesome to be on the board. Nick Kennedy was the next president. Shout out to Nick. He's a good friend. I still talk to him. And then here we are, you know, fast forward and ran for VP and, now president. So
yeah,
crazy.
I thought that was a dope move that when you ran for president, it was just you, no one else ran. And you're just like chilling up there. Like you knew in the back of your head, you're like, all right, like, you know, I still want to give a good speech, but like these guys, they know me, they know what's happening.
Sure.
But speaking of PBTO, cause we got to talk about it, you know, it's coming up and we want people to know about it. So tell us about PBTO and when it's going on this weekend, and you know, we'll have a clip of this so people can
go
out and watch it. Yeah,
and
yeah.
Hopefully, not hopefully, I'll make sure social repost it. So.
Yeah, yeah.
We run like one of the biggest basketball showcases in Western Massachusetts. I know they do one at the Basketball Hall of Fame, if I'm not mistaken, in Springfield. But other than that one, I think we're the only one. And it's obviously a huge undertaking.
Yeah.
But so worth the work. This is the biggest it's ever been. We knew eventually we'd have to move out of the Curry Hicks cage. Mm-hmm. It's where like, I think the track team practices there and a few other things happen there, but it's an old court. It's where UMass used to play like full time before Mullen Center.
Wow.
Very vintage. Back when like UMass was really good with like Dr. J and then there's a bunch of pictures of them in there. But so we were kind of forced into securing Mullen Center this year. I was hoping we could put it off for a few more years, but everybody just rose to the occasion. Like shout out to everybody on PBTO. The leadership, from Ari and Cam, who's the director, Professor Must helping out, was able to get a bunch of sponsorships from Crayley, who's running sponsorships, and Secure Mullen Center. Sophie Gindy and Aiden, I call him Aiden Erickson. His full name is Aiden Erickson Mullane, but I just call him like Aiden EM.
Yeah.
Aiden. They were able to, put together a really cool slate of games. So this weekend it'll start on Friday, I think at 4 or 4:30. All the times are on the Instagram or the website, PVTO. I think that's Instagram, it's PV Tip Off.
I think it
is. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Starts at 4 or 4:30. There'll be three games on Friday, kind of work us into the event. And then Saturday, I'm up at 7, same with the rest of the team. But I think the first game is, I want to say 10 or 10:30, maybe even earlier, actually. It might be earlier than that. But runs all day Saturday morning to Saturday night. Typically in the past, we've done 3 days. Yeah. And Sunday would be a prep school day where we're bringing people from prep schools. Tends to be, I don't want to say higher level competition, but just like a lot of those guys, basketball is their plan. They're doing. It's not like a public school. So the reason we like that is, we get some really awesome clips. Mm-hmm. We're able to bring in some really talented players who hopefully go on and play good college ball. But the return on like fans coming, because they're coming from far away, they don't bring a lot of fans. And also just the complexity of organizing it was a lot this year. We were sad about having to cut that day, but in looking at it now, I'm really happy we did, because the event's gonna be awesome.
Awesome. Well, if you guys are near the Massachusetts area, come by. And if you're not, if you're from where I'm from, Long Island, New York, send them a DM, just congratulating them. It's a big deal, and that's awesome to do. And we're gonna see how it goes, and that's exciting. Another thing I want to talk about, because I didn't know originally you were in an acapella group. And that's exciting. That's hype, because I also was in an acapella group. Not right now, but I was in high school.
Okay.
So the number one thing I like to ask people that are in acapella groups, and we'll go down the line, even though you two, you're not in an acapella group, but I've heard you guys sing. What do you mean? You guys are good at singing.
No, go ahead. I don't know about that.
What is the your go-to karaoke song? So I'll start with Cass, and we'll go down the line.
Me? You didn't give me any time to think.
Okay, you want me to go first?
Yeah, can you go first? All
right, I'll give you my top three. Okay, so Rock Your Body, Justin Timberlake.
Sure.
You played that. What else? Another one I like to be singing, let me think. I think any Michael Jackson song that's not like crazy high. So like PYT, that's a classic.
Yep.
And then the third, I don't know. I'm just going to stick with two. Those two are like PYT and Rock Your Body are the two I always go to.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. So I would say I'll give a few, but I'm Yours. That's like, it's just like a good song.
Yeah.
It's like one of the first songs I ever sang when I started singing when I was younger.
Yeah.
I sang that song at doing karaoke. I was in Barcelona, at an Americanized sort of bar. It wasn't like a Spanish bar. It was like specifically for like Americans and people from the UK and stuff. And I remember singing that song, and I was like, I was tired. It was late. I was, not feeling it, but that brought the crowd up. So
let's go.
That was a good time.
That's hype.
Not the best I've ever sounded, but that was really fun. And then I would say, I really like any of what's it called? It goes, today is gonna be the day. I have to sing the whole song to think of how it goes.
Wonderwall.
Yeah. Dude, they're gonna roast me for
that. Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, Wonderwall. Love Wonderwall. Love anything like Oasis. So anyway.
Okay, nice.
I think, well, first of all, Steven, I feel like your third one, if you had one, I don't want to put words in your mouth, but maybe Life is a Highway.
Because
I've seen you do that
song.
One.
That is a classic.
I feel like you're pretty good at that one, too.
It's not like a karaoke song. Child's Play by Drake.
Child's Play.
Yeah.
That is one of my favorite songs.
Life is a Highway, Cars. Shout out to Cars.
Shout out to Cars.
Lightning McQueen, man.
We went on this road trip. I guess it's like a side note. We went on this road trip for, was it Columbus Day?
Yeah, that sounds good.
We all went to my house. It was like them two and their two friends, Mara and Azrina.
Yeah.
And
Shout out.
We had this whole playlist, because it's like a 4-hour drive to get to my house in New Jersey. And he's saying Life is a Highway, and he did these little
at least like five times on the drive there. And five times on the drive back.
Worth. Yeah.
And five times while we were there.
And then in the middle, there's a little guitar part that there's no singing, right? And so sometimes I hit a little country rap.
You
would
just freestyle.
Oh, okay. I freestyle the country rap.
I feel you.
Because all you need in a country rap, if anyone wants to know out there, is boots, beer, trucks, and... I don't know, and Jesus. I think those are the four. Yeah, right. I feel like I'm missing one, but those are like the components.
No, sounds right to me.
And it's hard to drive when you're cracking up from like listening to him in the back, like trying.
What part of Jersey are you from?
Okay, it depends if you believe in Central Jersey. So I don't understand if you understand the whole.
I was born in Princeton.
Okay, so I'm like below Princeton.
Okay,
so like I'm in Union County.
Union. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I've been. I was born in Princeton. And I have friends in like North, like West Orange.
I'm in North, basically. Okay. So Central North. Yeah.
Okay.
It's like smack dab in the middle. But,
interesting.
Yeah, I've driven to Princeton before.
Yeah, it's a nice place. It's fancy. Beautiful. Very, very.
Okay, Drew. What's your come on?
Well, okay. So I would think if there's one that's like not really a karaoke song, I would probably have to say like Nonstop by Drake, because like that's a good one. I can hit like most of the lyrics to that, right? But then a non karaoke song that you and I did in New Jersey would probably be Bohemian Rhapsody.
Ooh, crazy. Yeah, Drew kills it.
Really?
Oh, yeah. I don't know if I kill it, but...
Yeah, you kill it.
I don't think I kill it, but...
Okay, okay. Cass?
I feel like I have a couple. So, like, I like Locked Out of Heaven.
Okay, that's true. That's a good...
Bruno Mars. Bruno Mars. I just want to say right now, for the pod, Bruno Mars has gone from, like, somebody who, like... I liked him, don't get me wrong, to now, like, with Silk Sonic and everything, and, I love Anderson .Paak. To like somebody who like shout out to Bruno Mars.
Yeah. I think my roommate also, but also you. I talk about music about a lot with Steven. Like when they drop their like tour dates for Silk Sonic, I'm gonna like pre-sale, drop as much money as I can.
Dude, I'm there. I'm there.
We gotta go.
I'll see you guys there.
I'll
see you guys there
in Boston.
If
I'm like Locked Out of Heaven, like oh my god, it's like when Runaway Baby.
We'll tell our friend Mert, who's at UPC, to get him to come for spring concert.
That's true.
No.
Did you know about Ty Verdes? Okay. Let me get something off my chest.
Tell us,
let me get something off my chest. Free tickets, right?
Yeah.
So immediately I'm like, these are gonna go. So I get one. I'm trying to get two. So because like I wanted it to get one for somebody else. Could only get one, obviously it makes sense, or else people would just get a bunch. And I'm like, I'm texting my friend. I'm like, hey, like, you know, you need to get this ticket. Like this is happening.
Yeah, get on it.
And she's like, oh, it's whatever. I don't really know him that well, but I'll listen, whatever.
Yeah.
She texts me. She's like, oh, it's sold out. Yeah. I'm like, all right, well, I guess I'm going alone. Like,
yeah.
Like, you know, frick you. Yeah. And then I forgot about it. And last night I look at my phone. To be fair, I couldn't have gone anyway. I had an acapella event last night. We were like pitching new songs and stuff like that at the end of the semester. But, I was like, oh my God, I forgot about the I saw it on everybody's stories. People are in the front row. Like, it's so like intimate. I'm like, I'm so mad.
Yeah.
But yeah.
Anyway, yeah, no, definitely got to see when that tour.
That album, I said this
we
before.
I love
Bruno Mars, but I even think that Anderson .Paak might have like
bodied him a little bit
on this album.
Okay, he's an incredible musician.
Yeah, because I think also because he was so underrated and not a lot of people knew him that you know what Bruno can do.
Sure.
And I think not a lot of people knew what Anderson can do, and so when he pulled up and he.
It kind of elevated. Which is interesting because like Bruno Mars is like, you know, internationally famous.
Yeah.
Anderson .Paak, so like it's funny that you say that because like specifically my acapella group, we have like, you know, our own sound and kind of the people that we all listen to. It tends to be similar because we're similar vibes musically. And it's a lot of people who are, I wouldn't say are unknown, but are definitely more like fringe as far as being super popular. Mm-hmm. And one of those people, Anderson .Paak, like we all know him, love him. Many people in the group have seen him live and like, he's like, to us, he's huge, you know what I mean? But then thinking about it, like, to people who don't know him and a lot of the world who doesn't, like him, like kind of working with Bruno Mars, probably, like you said, just showed off his talent.
Yeah. He also opened up for Bruno Mars on, like, I think it, don't know what tour, I think it wasn't the 24 Karat.
No,
one.
I think it was in Europe.
Oh, in Europe. Dua Lipa did the USA one, Anderson .Paak did the Europe one for 24 Karat. And, like, even then, like, I knew who he was because I listened to some of his music, but, like, he would never be an opener now.
He'd be the main show.
He
would. And Tiny Desk, by the way, like his Tiny Desk concert, incredible.
Me and my dad, shout out to my dad. We would watch that like over and over again, that Tiny Desk.
And I watch a lot of Tiny Desk. Like I love Tiny Desk concerts. And over the years I've tried to like figure out which are the best ones.
Yeah.
And it's so hard because there's so many good ones. And like, you have like the OG Tiny Desk. It was like really early when they first started doing, like, yeah. Dell was on it and hers was incredible. And then some of the newer ones, they did like the virtual ones like at home.
Yeah.
During COVID. And Justin Bieber.
I saw that one.
He's evolved, man. Like, talk about an artist that has.
Thank you. Oh,
like,
my goodness,
I love Justin Bieber's new album. I love that he works with John Bellion, who's like one of my favorite artists of all time.
John Bellion.
Yeah, he's
Sam, we gotta go on a date.
Yeah.
Because I love John Bellion. Yeah. And Justin Bieber's in my top five Spotify rap. Yeah. And everyone was clowning me.
No.
And I was like, bro, you have to listen to him. Changed, like, he's so good now.
You
like,
should
he's not
see
just...
Steven when Yummy comes on. Oh my god. He just goes crazy.
Because even Yummy is just like a bop. Like, it's like, sure, obviously, yeah. It's like, okay, like the lyrics is like, yeah, hey, whatever. Yeah. But like,
or I'm the one.
His voice is just a vibe. His voice is just so smooth. And yeah, John Bellion, like, I saw him in concert because he's from Long Island.
I'm so jealous. I know he's from New York.
And he he's crazy good. My friends, they'll watch this and they love John Bellion.
So you asked about my acapella group. That has been a very new thing for me in college. I never did anything like that in high school.
Yeah.
I did choir, but shout out my Lebanon choir. But yeah, the separate of acapella, which is kind of like, we love singing together. I love acapella music. I've learned to love it more. Our group isn't super like acapella-y, you know what I mean? Or like musical theater-y or at all. Like, none of us are really music majors. We all do our own thing. But, you know, so separate of that, I'd always done my own music. And like, I play the guitar and the piano and I sing and write music. And so John Bellion has always been like one of my biggest inspirations because, you know, first of all, he's really transparent about like how he makes music. All those YouTube videos I'm sure you've watched of him producing different albums and like the mini movies that he makes. And now, I mean, it pulls me both ways because I love that he's kind of now decided he's going to be only on the producing end and like writing. I know he released a song recently, but, you know, I wish he put out another album.
That's what all, like, literally when you say that, all my friends are like in love with him, and I like him a lot too. Yeah. And he manages for this band called Lawrence. I've talked to them about it sometimes, but they're like kind of like not a lot of people know about them, but they're crazy good. And and him too, it's like he's producing so, like, people don't know he produced like Camila Cabello, Justin Bieber, like Rihanna. He wrote I forgot the song, Love the Way You Lie, maybe, or one of those songs.
One of them,
like,
one
of those. And like, it's crazy to me that he like,
oh, his discography is crazy.
He kind of reminds me of Benny Blanco.
Yeah.
Because like, it's like Benny Blanco did, like, he did all Katy Perry's old songs, like The One That Got Away, E.T.
Mike Posner did a lot of Mike Posner stuff.
So it's like,
back in the day,
you have all these people who like are like really famous, then also have famous people producing the music. Like, I'm not as into music as like I'm assuming we both are, but it's interesting to see how like they can also release music but also be behind like all of your favorite songs.
Yeah. And honestly, like, yeah, that, I mean, that initially that was the goal for me. I wanted to do music. I still do it, but I had, like, kind of going into college, you don't have to make a final decision. You know, life is really long.
Yeah.
But I did have to sort of figure out, okay, like, which path am I going to take here? And I decided on sport management. I'm really, like, thankful, like, lucky that I had another thing other than music to sort of decide between. But if I were to do music, it, like, full-time and as a job, it would be something along the lines of John Bellion, where I would write, you know, I'd be a songwriter for someone, for people, do a little production, and then hopefully do my own stuff too. But no, John Bellion, like, I mean, he also did stuff for like Ariana Grande, and I don't know. I think just the ability to do music is, and see artists that, like you said, maybe not as many people know. I love, like, his thing is like, he doesn't want to be known. Like, he's like, not that he doesn't want to be known, but I think he kind of is like, I make my music, and I know that my product is quality. Like, if you want to listen, they want to listen.
Yeah.
That's that. You know what I mean?
And I even get frustrated with that sometimes. Like, my friends are like, well, you know, like, he only wants to release a couple of stuff. He doesn't want to get too big, which I understand.
Sure.
You know what I mean? No one, like, some people don't want that. Like, want the fame. They don't want to talk about their family online. Like, all this stuff. But I also am like, you have a talent. Like, you are so good.
Yeah.
And, like, my big thing has always been, like, and if I ever became something like that, it's like, it's all about the fans.
Yeah.
And like, that gets me frustrated with like people, like, you know, Frank Ocean, like,
of course.
And everyone loves Frank Ocean, but it gets me mad because I'm like, your fans want you so bad to like perform and to release music. And I understand it's like a, you know, it's a process and you want to release the best stuff.
When
but
have,
like, it's also like they made, like, they made a lot of what you are now.
They made all
like,
of it.
Yeah,
and I get that. I think the one thing you have to, like, for as somebody who like when I perform music live and stuff and like, you know, I think the fans are number one.
Yeah.
You also like as a songwriter, it's really hard to, it's not really hard. It's impossible to force it. Mm-hmm. Like there are months, yeah. There were months in my life between like senior year and college where I was starting to get like way better at songwriting. And I wrote, you know, maybe 12, 24 songs that were like all like quality music. And then over the last like year, I would say 6 months, I've written maybe 3.
Yeah.
And so mm-hmm. it comes in spurts. You know, obviously if you're paid to do it and it's what you wake up to do, I feel like it's a different level of expectation. So I'm not making an excuse, but, I get what you mean about the fans. It's that balance. Like you want to reward your fans. You want to give them what they want because they made you, but also you are a person and you know, yeah, I agree with what you're saying. I don't want artists to like sit on their laurels. Like I release my music, mm-hmm. I'm wealthy, I'm chilling. Like, mm-hmm. you know, if you're really about the art, then just keep releasing it. At least John Bellion's still working, you know, at least
exactly.
he's still putting out
That's something, true.
Even if it's not his own stuff.
That's true. And he does like love his fans and, you know, and all of them I think do. It's just, it's always like, it's a balance, right? It's like, you don't want to be number one on the charts and always releasing music. And then it's like,
and selling your soul. Like there are artists who are like,
they have a life.
Are artists who like literally, like they party every day of the week, you know what I mean? Mm. And there's nothing wrong with that if that's what makes you happy. But, you know, they then it takes a hit on their music. And so they may be number one on the charts, but like they're not writing their own lyrics. Mm. Their vocals really aren't that great. Like in the studio, they can make them sound great, but live they're not. And it's like, why would you, there's no reason to want that. You know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And they do other things in their outside life. You know, like we all do other things outside of what we're focused on, what our passion is.
Yeah.
Like you said, I mean, I do sport management and some people don't know about music, or the people who know about my music maybe don't know I'm a sport management major.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or like that I love lacrosse. Like that was my main thing growing up was lacrosse. I'm still in love with lacrosse. I coached lacrosse.
Yeah.
At Amherst High School last season. And so like these are things that people don't know about, but like kind of what you're passionate about. And, I don't know. Like if I could coach lacrosse and get paid good money to do it, man, like I'd strongly consider going into that as a career mm-hmm. instead of, something else. But
yeah. Well, I have a game for you guys. It's a game. We kind of been talking about music. It has music in it.
Oh shoot.
But it's, so if anyone watched the podcast from the beginning, from the jump, it's always almost been a year. We do a lot of tier lists on the podcast. We haven't brought it back. Cause my editor, Johnny, shout out Johnny. He has been at college, so you know he's been busy and doing tier lists does take some time. But you know what? I'm gonna make Johnny do some extra stuff today. So we have a tier list today of Christmas music. You know, it's not all Christmas music. No. That would take a long time. But these are just some classics that I found online that it was already pre-made. So we're gonna work with it today. If you guys in the comments want to drop down any songs that we missed, anything that you feel like should have been higher, lower, let me know. And thank you guys for watching. We're going to keep going. And all right. So the first song, 12 Days of Christmas.
Is that like the classic? Like
first day, that one?
That one?
Yeah.
I put that, personally, it wouldn't be like my go-to turn on the radio. And
I was going to say, what? No. So what are we rating for here?
Like, if it's like in rating the car, for like, or like your
are phone. That's true.
Or, like quality of music, or are we rating for like classic? You know what I mean? Like what are we doing here?
I feel like it's like, I don't know.
It's tough, right?
Maybe we should say like a mix of nostalgia with
classics.
Like if you have like
listening
a certain amount of songs left
to listen
to. Yeah. Right. Like you go in the car and you're like, I really want to listen to this song. Like
that's got to definitely then go pretty low for me.
Yeah.
I
think it's a
like
classic.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Like
and
it's cool, but like,
I would never turn it on.
No, it's not a bop.
It's one of those like family Christmas party it's like, okay, nice, but you're not singing it. Yeah.
No one ever sings.
All right, so where should we put it?
What's
good? I think good. Right now it's amazing, great, really good, okay.
Meh. I'm going to say okay.
I'll honestly. Say okay.
Okay.
Yeah, I would say okay too.
Yeah.
All right.
Also, I hope you guys like my mug. It's like handmade by some guy in Amherst.
Wow.
Shout out to the lacrosse team, Amherst High School lacrosse team. They gave this to me for coaching. So
that's right.
Just want to shout out.
Yo, they got to watch it.
Hopefully they will.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right. Next up, you know, the most selling song Christmas of all time.
Yeah.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Acapella group does this.
Oh.
We did this at my holiday concert.
Shoot.
It was. I think it was pretty good.
That's hype.
Anyway.
I mean, it's hard to, it has to be high.
I would.
It's overplayed.
To throw something out, I would put it at really good because it's overplayed. Like, it is good, but
it's way overplayed.
I say we can always move it around. I say we put it really good for now, and then we can move it. as well.
I'm very okay with that.
Okay. Like if it came on, I'd sing to it, but like it's still
there. Okay, my eyes are bad. What does that say?
Rocking Around the Christmas. Oh, amazing. Oh. Top tier.
Yeah, that's top tier. That's top tier. Yeah.
Like that's something as soon as you put on, everybody's vibing.
And it you know
like,
all the words.
That's when you put on when you're decorating the tree.
Good vibes.
Like everyone's eating dinner.
Shout out to the Jews, by the way, because I'm Jewish. Still celebrate Christmas, but anyway.
Happy Hanukkah.
Thank you.
That's what you said in last episode. You know, we love all
belated Hanukkah.
Hanukkah. Oh, yeah.
And that's ended, what I'm saying. Ended Monday.
Okay, well, it ended really early this year.
Yeah,
it
was really early. And Kwanzaa. Kwanzaa. And what's the next one? I can't see.
It's Dean Martin. What is that?
Ooh, is it Let It Snow? No.
No. What is that? I can't. I wish we could zoom. Oh, here we go. Oh. Baby, It's Cold Outside.
Oh. You know, controversial.
Baby, it's cold.
I think it's. But like, I like it. I think it's like probably be like I'm like really good. Like that's next to Mariah.
I would put that with.
Or it wouldn't be on the top. Maybe I'd be great.
I'd put it at great, dude. I think about it like. I don't
know. It's not as overplayed.
It's a duet. Yeah. It gives you warm, like, sit by the fire.
I would put it great. I put it great, too, for this reason.
I think a lot of people have duetted it. And, like, there's also, like, oh, I want to listen to the Josh Groban or the Denzel or, like, all those ones.
Even
when
I'm going to plug it, I hate to say it, the one from Glee.
You like the Glee one?
Okay.
Hey, don't know. I'm not going to tell anybody this in the podcast, but... kind of like Glee.
Hey. I'm a Glee lover, too. Okay.
This is... Oh, come all ye! This is a classic. It's one of those like.
Oh, come all ye!
Yeah.
Oh, come all ye faithful. That one.
Yeah.
Oh.
I don't listen to that one as much, but.
Oh my god! I'm
all that's okay. My computer.
I'll start it off by saying this. It's either, like the lowest tier or the best tier. Let me tell you why.
Yeah.
Because, if you get that blasting. On like a huge speaker, and it's dun, 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 or the like the rock version of it. I don't know if you guys have ever heard that. That slaps. Like I'm so for it.
Yeah.
But if it's just like the normal version and like it's kind of playing quietly, I'm like, what are we
yeah. That's true. Yeah. That's a rough one.
So all over the place.
So I think it has to be middle tier because then you get
both.
Well, how we put it on good.
Yeah. Okay.
Because it's like we don't have anything good, and like we're not like all like
All right, Frosty the Snowman.
Oh, I think.
I think that's like,
it's tough.
I think it's like,
I like that one. I personally like it.
Right, everyone knows the lyrics. The
movie but I don't want to listen to it. If it's on the radio, I'm skipping it.
See, if it's on the radio, I probably would skip it too. But the thought of like, it but not it's being like, high makes me sad.
But like, think of that song like as a kid though.
Yeah, like I said,
that's
like,
true.
Like
that's
not
thing,
now.
That's what I'm
as
saying.
A kid.
Like,
that's
a lot
true.
Of it not being on the thing.
I think it's definitely above 12 Days of Christmas. I think we can put it that good.
Yeah. I think we put it, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah. Are we getting to Michael Bublé? Because.
Oh, 100%. All
right, next up is some Carrie Underwood song.
Do you hear what I hear?
Oh.
Do you,
I'm sorry. It's a bop.
Yeah.
It's a bop. Even if it's not Carrie Underwood, just that song. I don't know who originally sings it, the guy.
Yeah.
Maybe it's Bing Crosby or
it's
something.
Probably one of the classics.
Yeah. So good.
But I don't have an opinion.
I think it just doesn't it just repeat?
Neither do I.
Or am I thinking? Is it just do you hear what I hear?
No, because then it's child, and then it's like said the dun dun to the little lamb.
Oh wow. I just don't know it that well. I'm gonna recuse myself from this one.
I don't like so you guys know like the Josh Groban song, it's like Noel.
Yeah.
It's like that one that's like my like the, I got that confused between that one.
Oh.
so
where
like,
should we put it? I
have
put
no
it good.
Opinion
we can put
I have
it
no
good.
Opinion
I have no opinion
I like it but
so then you call the shots then because it's like
you know it better
one of those songs
I put it as really good
really okay so it's above Frosty
for me
it is
well we'll come back to that
no we'll okay
no put it there for now but
okay.
we'll rearrange
we'll
all right now one of the Michael Bublé
okay
what is it
it's probably
Holly Jolly Christmas
yeah put that on top
dude. That's honestly, every Michael Bublé song's got to go on
this
album. I'm sorry. He's just...
I agree. Amazing.
Everyone says Mariah Carey's the Queen of Christmas.
No.
Michael Bublé's the King
yeah,
of Christmas.
Yeah.
Yeah. I agree.
Which one is that?
Bro, all these are so
Jingle
small.
Jingle Bell Rock.
Oh.
Ooh, that's a classic.
That's a classic.
That's
it's got to be either amazing or great.
Yeah.
My question
I think... Maybe at the end of Amazing. Like, it's not better
yeah,
than...
Yeah.
But, like,
yeah.
I'll never
around
skip
the Christmas
it.
Tree.
No, I would never skip it.
Yeah, you can put it on Amazing.
Yeah.
Funny how you do these tiers. SSS.
I didn't even. This is a one that was already made. Usually I write.
Oh,
usually there's like DF.
That's a sleeper.
That's a sleeper.
I saw
that,
Mommy Kissing Santa
that looks
Claus.
Like,
oh.
Yeah, because that was from the movie with Zach and Cody. Was
oh,
in
I thought Jackson 5 does that one too.
No, if no, they don't one? Have grandma hold got on, run over by a reindeer. I'm...
Or Mela Kanikiwaka.
That, yeah. So I saw mommy christening. Christening because it's Christmas.
Yeah.
I love it. I'm gonna just put it out there. I think it's a banger.
I like that one.
I don't think you guys remember how it goes, but
I don't remember.
I don't even care if this ruins the audio. We're gonna get a little taste of this.
Yeah.
Because yeah, and also if Grandma got.
Grandma got. I know. By
that's
reindeer.
That's like four S's.
You know my least favorite Christmas song is the All I Want for Christmas is My Two Front Teeth.
Oh yeah.
That one.
Ready?
Yeah.
It's just got that like energy to it, and it's by the Jackson 5, so like you know it's.
No, the
wow. You got the little intro with the nice. Wait. Right?
It's a good one.
Fire.
Yeah.
Fire.
Classic.
So we put in an amazing.
I think we should put it up
I think
there.
We should.
I yeah. agree.
It's underrated.
Is it better than Jingle Bell Rock or
no? Maybe we, yeah, maybe you put it great. Maybe we put it great. I don't know.
Yeah.
But I think it's great. Better than the Dean Martin.
Yeah. Yeah. Great before. Yeah.
All right. Another Michael Bublé.
Okay.
This is...
Speaking to look.
Oh, that's...
That went up to
so I think it's got to be the best one. I think it's got to be the best one.
But is it before?
It's before. The other one, it's yeah. before Holly yeah, Jolly
it's
okay. Christmas.
It's before. Probably the best.
Yes.
One of the best, if not the best Christmas song. To listen to. Let's just remind the,
yeah.
to listen,
the viewers
yes.
and listeners. Like, this isn't like musical genius. I mean, he is a musical genius, but anyway.
All right, next up is Mary Did You Know by Pentatonix. A cappella.
So controversial.
Okay.
I really like Pentatonix. I think they're talented. I think they've stayed relevant for so long, which is so hard to do in music, especially as an a cappella group. Mm-hmm. Popular a cappella group.
Yeah.
The only one. But they're so everybody loves their Christmas music. I don't think it's that great. I think it's a little campy, like a little like...
I can see that.
You know what I mean? Some of it is really good. This one, I specifically am not a huge fan of.
No.
But yeah. If some of you guys feel strongly.
I don't feel strongly.
I don't really have an opinion. I like them a lot, but I do think this is one of those that, like, I like that it's, you know, like, I don't think Mary Did You Know was a popular song
before
that.
Why did you have to make it into an
acapella
song?
Yeah.
Right. Really, really good as a cover was Hallelujah.
I do like Hallelujah.
They did that one really good. And then they took it and they, like, ran with it.
And the Daft Punk one.
Daft Punk is really
good. But I'm talking about Christmas.
She's talking about, like, Christmas vibes.
Yeah. Yeah.
I think we should put it, and I hate to be mean, just on the myth.
Me too.
Because we haven't put anything on it. We don't have anything there.
No, and I do think it's worse than all the other ones.
Yeah.
All
right, next is Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer.
That gives the same vibe as Frosted Snowman, but I think it's better.
Yeah, so I think it goes before on good.
On good, yep.
Yep.
Yeah, agreed.
Easy choice.
That worked itself out pretty well.
Okay.
Slide her over.
Come I don't on. Know why it won't slide, we'll but, go, we'll but you know.
Slide the other one, maybe Frosty, to the right.
Yeah.
Oh, that's so boy, what? It's okay. My
we'll figure it out.
Fix it.
We'll figure it out.
Shout out
my
Johnny.
Editor
shout out Johnny.
Shout out Johnny.
Let's go.
Apparently you know how to dance.
Oh, you know what's up.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
Oh.
Banger.
Banger.
Okay,
but is it better?
I think if I had to put it somewhere impersonally, I'd be like there.
You think so? At the bottom of great?
Bottom?
I think I think it's actually a little lower in my opinion.
Wow.
I think so too.
Maybe
I think
really good.
I think it's like
really good top.
Yeah.
Or with Mariah Carey.
Yeah, maybe next time, maybe in between.
Yeah, between Mariah Carey and this man's song that I don't even know that well.
Bro, fire. I forgot what it was. Silver Bells.
Silver Bells.
See, I love Silver Bells because from like a musical standpoint,
it's really
it's fucking sick.
Yeah.
Sorry, it is a great song.
No, you're good.
But would I like listen to it a lot? Probably not. Like I'd put it on if it was like cozy.
Yeah.
But
it's not my favorite slow Christmas song.
No.
Yeah.
It's gotta be for me above good tier. I think it's better than these ones as far as like
maybe at the end
at the end of really good. I'd be okay
at the end of really good.
Yeah, I'm okay with that.
It's a classic.
Yeah.
All right, now what is this one? Oh, Underneath the Tree. Kelly Clarkson.
You cannot stop listening. Both of them cannot stop listening to that one.
That's like on the top for me. Like
I'm sick of that song right now because I hear it at least 5 times a day.
I think
in the car.
I think it's not an amazing only because it hasn't been out for long enough. It hasn't like
it deemed it
done the
like
test
a,
of time.
Right.
Yeah.
So I think it's at the top of great.
Okay,
I think.
I can put it there. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that.
Yeah. We listen to that song a lot.
it's a good song. I'm just like sick of it.
Oh my god.
I'm dreaming
of a white Christmas.
Yeah.
Mid.
I think I put that. No, not mid. I feel like.
No, I think that's it's like maybe top of my... good.
Really?
Yeah. Maybe.
I think it's above Frosty.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Cass thinks it's high. Cass is high in the song.
I like that song. But I don't think it's better.
I think it's better than Silver Bells.
I think it's better than Silver Bells too.
That's a good point.
I would switch their spots. I'd drop Silver Bells down to good.
Yeah.
In front of Frosty, if we can. We wanted the other one in front of Frosty.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Oh, there we go.
Didn't we want
now try
the reindeer one in front of Frosty?
Oh, yeah.
Rudolph. There we go.
All right.
Look at us.
Okay, last two. I wish you a Merry Christmas. Is it like we wish you?
Maybe I want to make sure we know the right. This is the right song.
Yeah.
Look at us. We're not even cultured on Christmas.
You know what's up.
Hey, listen.
I wish you a Merry Christmas.
I thought that, maybe it's just the right. Maybe it's just we wish you a Merry Christmas.
No, I think it's different. Oh.
No.
Oh, this is just the OG.
Okay.
I don't like this one as much. Like I would skip it. I don't like it at all.
Yeah.
I think it's
okay.
I think it's meh.
Meh.
But better than Pentatonix.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd be okay with putting it okay. Just because it's a classic. All
right. And then last one is the most wonderful time of the year.
Oh, that's
up there. That's up there.
That reminds me of like the city, like going to the city, seeing the tree.
That's true.
Going to the rocket. Like that's like a classic.
Yeah.
I could honestly put it anywhere in Amazing.
Yeah.
Really? You'd put it that high?
I put it up there too.
Yeah.
That's a classic. All right. We listened to it the other day and it was a good
thing. Yeah, it is
a classic.
It has to
and it's the Sprite Cranberry ad.
All right.
Okay. So you gotta factor that in
too.
So should we put it at the end of Amazing or maybe?
Yeah.
We're gonna put it on Amazing, it's gotta be.
Which LeBron ended his contract with Sprite.
Really?
That's true. He's not gonna be doing this
contract. All right, so this sport badges too. All right, so this is the tier list. It'll be on the screen. It'll be on the screen.
Yep.
You know, we're definitely missing some, but let us know what you think in the comments about this tier list, what you would change. I think there's some missing here.
Yeah.
Like, I'll be home for Christmas.
I'll be home from Christmas. Classic. Last Christmas.
War is Over by John Lennon. That's like my favorite.
I've heard it. The most obvious one is Grandma Got Ran Over.
That is a fire one.
That's like four.
Not only is it a fire song, I don't know if you guys have ever seen the movie associated with it.
Yeah.
The like animated movie. Mm-hmm. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Piece of art, that is.
I haven't seen that one.
It's incredible.
There's a lot of ones that were missing. Like, I have to go. Yeah.
I think Last Christmas.
As much as Mistletoe by Justin Bieber.
Oh.
Fire. That's
okay, you know what? I'm going to put this out here right now. Mistletoe by Justin Bieber is top tier.
Yes.
I agree.
Maybe not Michael Bublé.
No.
But yeah. Close.
It's close.
Close. And like, oh, come on, dude.
And Santa Tell Me by Ariana Grande.
So everybody likes that. Everybody is, because every time I bring up Mistletoe,
yeah.
Like, shout out to... You know who you are. Every time I bring up Mistletoe, somebody else also brings up Ariana Grande and her Christmas music. And listen, I love Ariana Grande.
Yeah.
I think she's a great singer. There's just, like her voice to me is like her music.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I can never hear her sing a cover. Because every time she does, I'm like, I just want you to sing your music. Because you do it.
Yeah,
only you
true.
Can do your music.
That's true.
It's the same thing with like, I'm trying to think of another artist that's like that to me, but it doesn't come to mind right away. But yeah, I mean, Kelly Clarkson and, like, Carrie Underwood, they're kind of similar to me. Where, like, I don't really like when they do covers because I'm like, you guys have fantastic voices. Like, sing your music and like, kill that. But I have heard good things about her.
That one song. She has other good Christmas songs, but Santa Tell Me, I think, is a nostalgic thing.
Okay, yeah.
Because I have some friends at home that, like, would just blast it. Or, like, at church even. Like, after church, we listen to it and it would go crazy.
Yeah.
Well, thank you guys for this tier list. It's going to be on the screen. Like I said, let us know. And thank you for coming on, Sam.
Of course, yeah.
It was a lot of fun. You're going to be on again. You know what's up.
I'll be here.
You know what's up. You got time.
We need to cycle some people out.
Exactly. Right. These guys, I'm kicking them out. No, I'm just kidding. They've been good. But...
I'm going to co-host. That's the long goal.
That's the goal. Hey, you never know. At UMass.
You guys can be on each side. And interrogate the people in the middle.
Yeah.
Cody Kohu. Cody and Noel.
Exactly. That's true. We're going up the Goober podcast. Thank you guys for watching today.
I love you, Cody.
Thank you guys for watching today. And thank you, Sam, for coming on. I know a lot of your friends will be watching. So
hopefully.
How's it going, Sam, friends?
Hello.
MSL people. You guys got to be watching.
Yeah.
They got to be watching.
MSL.
Yep. And a reminder again about PVTO. Go check it out. There's going to be a clip of it out before the podcast. So you'll be able to see it. But yeah, thank you guys for coming on. Thank you for watching. Follow us at the Goober Pod on Instagram. Subscribe, like, comment down below. And let us know who you want to see next. And peace out, guys. Peace.
Peace.